Have you ever had a friend who lost a pet, big or small? The grief this causes is sometimes more deep and intense than the loss of a family member. With these 10 tips, you can support your friend and show you care. My name is Betty Heideman. I run since 20 years a home for old, ill and handicapped dogs and cats and sometimes other small animals. I have said farewell almost 100 times, so you can say I know about hurt and grief. Tip 10. Suggest your friend to create a memorial box together. A memorial box, or memory box, can contain items that belong to the animal, like a toy, its paws, a blanket, and/or pictures. It could also include some hair in a little bottle. The box can be of any material. It can be new, or maybe a beautiful box you found on a yard sale. You can also buy a cardboard or wooden box and paint or decorate it. You can put the name of the animal on it, and it will be a very beautiful memory. Tip 9. Talk to your friend about his or her feelings. Maybe he or she is feeling guilt, which is very common that pet owners, even though I don't really like the word owners, we don't own our pets, that they feel guilty for letting their animal go in case of euthanasia, or in case the animal had an accident. Guilt is a very powerful and negative emotion. Help your friend to talk about it and to explain that he or she has no need to feel guilty. Tip 8. Care for your friend. Maybe the animal was the only living creature in their house. Especially with elder people, this happens a lot. They start to neglect themselves. Life has lost its meaning for them. Make sure your friend is eating and drinking and taking care of herself. Take them out, even if it's for a little walk, especially when someone has lost a dog and is used to go out a couple of times a day. It's very helpful to go for a little stroll. Tip 7. Don't let looks fool you. Maybe your friend is very good in putting up a poker face or a smile of a clown. But he or she might feel completely lost inside, desperate, depressed. So many people are ashamed to show their feelings when it is about losing a pet. And they just say they are fine, but inside they feel like they're dying. So don't settle for the obvious, I am fine, when you ask how they are doing. Tip 6. Let your friend tell about the animal. Recall memories. Laugh about funny things the animal did. Collect pictures together, maybe to make a collage or a print. Talking about a pet keeps it alive. And of course, it's fine if your friend starts to cry and you can cry together. But let them tell how beautiful the animal was, how naughty the animal was, and maybe sometimes how angry your friend was with the animal. It's all fine. Tip 5. Help your friend clean out a cage, basket or stable. It's a very difficult task to perform if you have lost a pet. And someone who is willing to help you with this task will not only bring comfort, but it also shows that they are not alone in their sorrow and grief. Tip 4. Even though these are hard times to show affection, don't be afraid to put your arm around your friend, to give him or her a big hug and hold each other. And if your friend starts to cry, let him or her cry, and like I said, cry together. Human contact is something we all need, especially in difficult times. Tip 3. Maybe you're not living very close to your friend. Then you always have the option to send a sympathy card or a gift. There comes so much comfort from a real sign of caring. And don't forget to ask on a regular basis how they are doing. The hurt is not over in a week, not even in a month, and maybe some people more in a year or longer. Tip 2. Offer to go with your friend to the vet or be with your friend at home if the animal is euthanized, especially when your friend is single and has no one else. Going through this alone, no person should go through this alone. And even though you don't have to say anything, you can just be there. Also afterwards, just be there. Be a friend. Tip 1. It's good to talk about the wishes your friend has for him, his or her pet. A lot of people don't want to talk about this. They don't want to think about the fact that the pet will eventually die. What does your friend want? Does your friend want that the animal is cremated or buried, or maybe they want to leave it at the vet? There are so many options nowadays. Talk about it. It's good to talk about that. And it's important to know what a person wants. Do they want to keep some hairs, a paw print, or some ashes? Knowing in advance will avoid having to make these difficult decisions when the animal has passed and your friend is full of grief. It's like with humans. It's better to know in advance. Bonus tip. Many people nowadays have the pictures of their loved ones only on their telephone. And not seldom those pictures are lost when a telephone gets damaged or lost. Also, there are a lot of telephones that don't make really good pictures. My personal advice is to make sure you have a few really good, sharp, high resolution pictures of your pet. I make a lot of collage for people when the pet has passed. And unfortunately, it happens very often that the pictures they have are too low in resolution for me to work with. So whether you make pictures with a real photo camera, or you have someone make them for you, or you can do a photo shoot together with the animal, one of the greatest comforts you can have can be a very nice photo to look at on the wall, on the shelf, or other. And don't forget to make some videos too. Well, my dear friends, I would like to say I hope you never have to lose a pet, but that would mean you would never have a pet. We all know when we adopt a pet, give them a home, there will be a time that we have to say our farewells. So, if you can help a friend with any of these tips, that would be a wonderful thing. Thank you for listening. Have a lovely day. And again, if you're coming up or a friend is coming up with this difficult decision, leave a comment below and I will respond to it. Big kiss from your friend Betty.